Hi everyone, today we're going to be doing a Jennifer Lopez look, and it's a request made by Jeannie and a load of other people, but I've got Jeannie's name, so I'm going to give her a shout out. It's a slightly silvery look with white, and it's not a cheap look. The products I'm using tonight are MAC and Stila. So that's all I've got in the colours, because I've been trying to find out a colour that'll go. But here we go, we'll start, and I'll show a picture at the end as well. First we're going to apply some bronzer, and I'm using this one because it's got shimmer in it, and she's very shimmery, and you'll see at the end. I'm going to do some photos as well, and I've got a new camera, so I do look a bit different, but let's hope it's not pixelated. I'm going to try and keep it between the 12 minute limit and not over the top, so I don't want to compress it and make it look terrible. So first you're going to take some bronzer, and you're just going to gently sweep it in a C shape, in the shape of a 3, across your cheekbones, from your little temples of your forehead down, and then to underneath here. And it just gives a bit of a shade. And it also, you'll find, it might just slim your face down a little bit as well, if you're lucky. Because I like doing this. It does help me. Just doing the bronzer in the shape of a 3. I've actually felt a little bit down lately. So I'm just picking myself up and coming on here and cheering myself up. Because I felt like just going back to bed. I feel really depressed. I don't know why. Stupid really, I know. But you see the bronzer. Mm-hmm. Right. Now, take a little bit, the same again, because she's got bronzer on her cheeks as well. You start from here and just gently rub, and use the side of the brush if you can, and just gently rub it back up into your hairline, basically, at an angle. So you're kind of covering the line, your cheek line, so you just got a nice contour. Same on this side. I'm also on here a bit earlier than usual because I want to hang around at the end of my video upload to talk to you all, because it's just getting beyond a joke. I never have the time to stick around afterwards because it's too late in the morning and I like to go to bed, so at least this time it's early. Now what we're going to do is we're going to apply some of the Stila Smokey Stila Shadow Pot Eye Mousse, and we're just going to apply that dead gentle, any finger you want. I'm using the middle. You can use a brush if you want. I'm choosing a finger. I'm just gently blending it back and forth until you've created a nice creamy base. You're going up to your eyebrow bone, so you want right up. Just cover the whole eye area like that, because you're going to be blending white onto it anyway, so you'll not have it looking all grey. But this is just to get the colour on, and then we'll build on top of this soon. Same again, just keep applying it, just so you cover the whole eyelid area. The look she's got is just absolutely beautiful, and it's not too overpowering either, which I know you all love. I'm always getting asked to do neutrals. This request was asked for ages ago. That's how far behind we are. My inbox is jumping. It is deadly. So I feel guilty. I go to bed stressed because I can't reply to everyone. But so that's another reason why I'm going to hang around after the video, because it's early enough. I don't have to be in bed just yet. It's only 6 o'clock tea time. And then I can talk to yous, because usually it's like 4 in the morning when my videos finish uploading, and I'm usually in bed, you know. But not the day. So well, now we're going to take some. We've got it. I think I'm going to have to put all the details at the end after I've taken them out the things, because you see, I'm going to have to take them out with my fingers and I can't just yet. So I will at the end of the video when I'm done. Where is that brush? I've just cleaned it. That'll do. Now the orange eyeshadow out of the Alia palette spilled all over on the brush set, so they've got orange polka dot bits on. I don't know. But anyway, now you're going to take this one here. I call it moth dust. Looks like moth dust. You know any squish a moth? A house one? Just looks like that. So you're just going to apply that all over your eyelid, going up to your crease only. Because you don't want to go above it, because we're going to be blending something else above it. So just go up your crease. Same on the other side. It's a pretty simple look. And I've checked that all the products are still available, because I was going to be using MAC pigment in silver, but I think that's long discontinued, so that's no good for you, is it? I'm really trying my best not to use stuff. A lot of the stuff I've got that are rare because they were in samples of ages ago. So, but I'm trying my best not to use them. I'll come up with alternatives. And I know I still have these. So now this one I'm sure is pewter. I'm sure. It's like a dark charcoal silver grey. Take that with using like a rounded swish brush. I call it a swish brush, but it's great for blending in the crease. You only want a little bit. Itchy nose. You only want a little bit, and you just want to take it out the corner, just gentle. And give it a bit of a swoosh. Meaning blend. Just me a little word I made up, a bit of a swoosh. So you want to just swish it into the corner. Just dipped it into the wrong one. And same again on the other side. Just gently, you don't want too much. And then the same, just blend it right into the inner corner. And then go up. It's quite a dark look, and it looks like it's come out there, but it's not. It's just shadowing. Odd. And same again on this side, just bring it right up this time. I've got to go to the dentist tomorrow morning. I've got to see the hygienist. It's been a great pleasure to be there. Dentists are usually horrendous, in my opinion. I haven't had a great one yet. This one is brilliant. And they're helping us with my teeth. I'm getting the front three that are funny fixed, which I'm more than worried about. But I think that's it. I'm sure it's just the three at the front on the top getting done. And they do need doing because they don't look very nice at all. And I'm always ashamed to go out with them. So anyway, liner brush. Again with your pewter, the bottom corner. Just line the lower lash line. Now this, 1, 2, 3, bang the room. Right, I don't know what happened there. I think it's because my camera was full because I didn't clean the last lot off. Naughty animal. I promised I would, but I must have just got lazy and left it on. So, what we've done, we've blended the pewter up into the eyebrow bone. Same on this side. Now, with the look, she's actually got really dark lashes, so we're going to pretend, and we're going to take, if I can find it, here it is, it's by Stila, and it's Onyx, and it's a convertible eye pen, and we're going to practically tight line, but not quite. Just going to run this back and forth along the eyelash line, just to darken it. It really does help. I'm practically just dragging it through my lashes, because I've noticed when I put it on under the skin, it bleeds into the corner of my eye, and then you end up with a load of black gunk, which isn't pretty. And by the time you've got rid of your black gunk, you've took half your makeup out the corner of your eye off. So I'm just applying this, just teasing it through the hair onto the skin, just gently. If you do it, you'll know what I mean. Saves going underneath, because it kills my eye. It stings like mad when I put it on the skin underneath. So you're not doing the whole lot. Look, just a tiny darkens the lashes, makes it look like you've got a bit more, because we haven't got time to do false. I will be doing a tutorial on false soon, just getting around to doing them all, and I don't want to leave anybody out either. But now that we've done that, I'm going to take some MAC pigment, just using a quick sample I've got. It's a little white one, it's just white, and we're going to take that with a little brush. There we go, just a little one. We're going to apply it in the inner corner of the eyelid, like that. In the inner, and run it up along the nose line as well, because she's got it blended right in. The inner corner is lovely and white on her. And then once you've done that, you want to take a little bit more and run it along the lower, just gently. Same on the other side. I'm trying to make my videos stay to 12 and no longer, because I've noticed it takes forever to upload to YouTube, and I mean practically overnight. So it's just ridiculous. Plus it gets boring, it really does. So I'm trying to keep it lower for you, and it won't need to compress it, and I think that's why my last video was pixelated. That's why I removed it. There was no point in it being up, it was terrible. And there you go. So you've got your white on the in corners. Now, take some more pewter with the liner brush. That's what we were doing when the camera cut off. Take your pewter again. And you just line the lower lash line. Just gently. And blend it in with the white we've just put on. Same on this side. Just gently. You want to do it dry as well. You don't want it too dark, because hers is a very light look. It's almost pasteled. So you don't want it dark. This isn't a MAC Shark Skin shade stick look. Not today. We don't want it vibrant. So now that I've got that, I've got fluff up my nose off my brush, you want to take a little bit of the white pigment quickly with your foundation brush. Any foundation brush will do, even a little concealer brush, but I'm just using a foundation brush. dab it into your white pigment, back it off, and just gently tap, because she's got a wincy bit of highlight on her cheekbones. Looks very healthy on her, but I have a feeling I'm doing it wrong, but we'll go anyway. And then, oops, don't put loads on or you look like a sweaty beast. Just blend that into your cheekbones so it's going over the top of your bronzer and it looks quite pretty. Now take your lipstick. I'm using Benefits Her Glossiness Life on the A-List. It's a beautiful neutral pink and she's got neutral lips, so this'll do. This is like a medium smoky eye. I love the way she's got hers. Plenty on, and it is divine. Smell, taste a lot, but I can imagine if you're out in the wind, your face is just gonna get stuck to your hair. Then you put your mascara on. I'm using mascara, Plushlash. I've got a mascara X on order, hopefully. So, because I don't like this too much, the brush is a bit awkward to use, but just tip your head back. And she's got quite thick lashes. They really are completely fibred and thick, which I like the look of. I like mascara. So just tip your head back again to the side. I've done the complete face today and I hope it doesn't take too long. That's the problem. If you do things properly and you don't edit like I don't edit, I wish I should. But you've got to see from start to finish and then you kind of fit everything in. So I end up looking with eyes and nothing really else. But we've done kind of the whole lot today apart from the foundation. When you've got bronzer, it doesn't really matter. It's whatever you're comfortable with at the end of the day. I'm just running this across my lower lash line because she has got her bottom ones done. And I know some makeup artists out there don't like using it on the bottom, but what the hell, you do what you're comfortable with, don't you? And there you have it. Actually, no, quickly, I'm going to put a little bit of the white. Where's the brush I've just been using? Is that the brush? No. Och, where are you? Here we go. Just gently underneath the eyebrow, just to give it a lift. It all helps, doesn't it? There you are. And there you have it. A JLo inspired smoky eye look. I hope you enjoyed. Zoom, zoom.